गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट डीजल पावर स्टेशंस. फॉर जनरेटिंग इलेक्ट्रिकल पावर इट इज असेंशियल टू रोटेट द रोटर ऑफ एन ऑल्टरनेटर बाय मीन्स ऑफ ए प्राइम मूवर. हमें अगर इलेक्ट्रिकल पावर को जनरेट करना है तो हमें जो जनरेटर है उसके इनपुट पे हमें मैकेनिकल एनर्जी देना होगा बाय द मीन्स ऑफ ए प्राइम मूवर. अब ये प्राइम मूवर है वो डिफरेंट मेथड से हम उसको ड्राइव कर सकते हैं. यूजिंग डीजल इंजन एज प्राइम मूवर इज वन ऑफ द पॉपुलर मेथड्स. सो हम डीजल इंजन को एज ए प्राइम मूवर यूज कर सकते हैं टू गिव द मैकेनिकल एनर्जी टू द जनरेटर. When prime mover of the alternator is diesel engine, the power station is known as diesel power station. So the mechanical power required for driving this generator comes from the combustion of diesel. But ये जो plants हैं ये हम large scale पे इन plants के साथ हम electricity नहीं generate करते due to the high cost of the diesel. These plants are only used under emergency conditions. Or in combination with some other plants, so they are not individually used for generation of electricity in large scale. But for small scale production, where the other alternatives are not available, so diesel power stations can be used there. Steam power plant and hydro power plant, they are mainly used to produce the maximum portion of our electrical demand. So for steam power plant we require ample amount of steam or ample amount of coal, but for hydro power plant we require water after the construction of those dams. अगर हम डीजल पावर स्टेशन की बात करें तो ऐसा कोई भी रिक्वायरमेंट नहीं है. ये कहीं भी इंस्टॉल कर सकते हैं डीजल पावर स्टेशंस को. ऐसा कोई साइट सिलेक्शंस का प्रॉब्लम नहीं है डीजल पावर स्टेशन के केस में. सो दे आर पॉपुलरली यूज्ड फॉर द एज अ स्टैंड बाय फॉर डिफरेंट इंडस्ट्रीज, कमर्शियल कॉम्प्लेक्सेस, हॉस्पिटल्स एक्सेट्रा. Also during power cuts, these generating power generators are, these diesel power generators are run to fulfill the required electricity demand. So here you can see diesel engine में जो भी combustion हो रहा है. diesel engine की अलग से videos हैं, उसका link मैं आपको नीचे description box में दे दूंगी. You can go there for the proper, for understanding the proper functioning of the diesel engine. तो इसमें हमें fuel injection चाहिए, compressed air चाहिए और lubrication oil चाहिए, lubricating oil जो हमें चाहिए. तो ये तीन inputs हैं इसमें. तो जो fuel injectors हैं that is through fuel oil tank, उससे filters के through होते हुए via pump we are giving that fuel to the diesel engine. Then the compressed air through the compressor and filter, compressed air गई, compressed air plus fuel, उसके बाद जो lubricating oil है, that is from the lubricating oil tank. तो ये तीन चीजें input गई हैं diesel engine को. उसके बाद जो यहाँ से mechanical energy generate हुई, that will be given as an input to the generator. फिर exhaust gases through the silencer. Then the cooling water is also required for cooling purposes. Cooling water, then through pump we are giving it as an input. अब जो lubrication है, जो lubrication का purpose जो lubricating oil ने किया, जैसे उसका purpose खत्म हुआ it will come as an output. तो उसको जो उसमें हीट होगी डैट विल बी कूल डाउन विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस कूल वाटर. दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द डीजल पावर स्टेशन. जो डीजल इंजन का वर्किंग है डैट यू कैन गो टू डैट लिंक एंड सी इट्स वर्किंग. So these are advantages of diesel power station. They are very simple in design. They require less space. They can be quickly start. जैसे कि हम स्टीम पावर प्लांट में देख रहे हैं, दे विल टेक 5 to 6 आवर्स फॉर स्टार्टिंग, बट दे कैन बी क्विकली स्टार्ट. डीजल पावर स्टेशंस, दे कैन बी स्टॉप्ड व्हेन रिक्वायर्ड, एज दीज मशीन्स कैन इजीली बी स्टार्टेड एंड स्टॉप्ड व्हेन रिक्वायर्स. देयर मे नॉट बी एनी स्टैंड बाय लॉस इन द सिस्टम. कूलिंग इज ईजी एंड रिक्वायर्ड स्मॉल क्वान्टिटी ऑफ वाटर. Initial cost is less as compared to other power stations. Thermal efficiency of diesel is higher than that of coal. So these are some advantages of diesel power station. Some disadvantages of these plants, it includes, as we've already mentioned, the cost of diesel is very high as compared to coal. This is the main reason for which a diesel power plant is not getting popularity over other means of generating power. In other words, the running cost of this plant is higher as compared to steam or hydropower plants. Secondly, the plant generally used for to produce small power requirements. Then the cost of lubrication is high. Then the maintenance is quite complex and cost is high for maintenance. Then plant does not work satisfactorily under overload conditions for a longer period. So the different components of diesel power station. In addition to diesel generator set or DG set, there are many other auxiliary attached to at diesel power stations. So let us discuss one by one. First one is fuel supply system. In fuel supply system, there is one storage tank, fuel transfer pump. From this pump, the fuel is given to the diesel engine. Storage tank is where the oil is stored before giving it to the engine. अब जो main tank में oil है, उसको हमने day tank में shift करना है. So during transferring from main tank to the smaller day tank, the oil is passed through the strainer to remove some solid impurities. So from day tank to main tank, there is another pipe connection. This is overflow pipe. This pipe connection is used to return the oil from day tank to main tank in the event of overflowing. So from day tank, the oil is injected in the diesel engine by means of a fuel injection pump. एयर इनटेक सिस्टम. अब फ्यूल को बर्न करने के लिए वी नीड एयर फॉर दैट. सो द एयर इनटेक सिस्टम विल सप्लाई नेसेसरी एयर टू द इंजन फॉर फ्यूल कंबस्शन. इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ अ पाइप फॉर सप्लाइंग ऑफ फ्रेश एयर टू द इंजन. फिल्टर्स आर ऑल्सो प्रोवाइडेड टू रिमूव डस्ट पार्टिकल्स फ्रॉम एयर बिकॉज दिस पार्टिकल्स कैन एक्ट एज एन एब्रेसिव इन द इंजन सिलेंडर. देन द एग्जॉस्ट सिस्टम. Exhaust system is for removing exhaust gases from the engine to the atmosphere by means of this exhaust system. A silencer is normally used in the system to reduce noise level of the engine. Then the cooling system. The heat produced during internal combustion drives the engine. But some part of this heat raises the temperature of different parts of the engine. So this high temperature may cause permanent damage to that machine. Hence it is very essential to maintain the overall temperature of the engine to a tolerable level. Cooling system of diesel power station does exactly so. The cooling system requires a water source, water pump and cooling towers. The pump circulates water through cylinder and head jacket. The water takes away heat from the engine and it becomes hot. The hot water is then cooled by cooling towers and it is recirculated for cooling. Then the lubricating system. This system minimizes the wearing of rubbing surface of the engine. Here lubricating oil is stored in lubricating oil tank. This oil is then drawn from the tank by means of oil pump. Then the oil is passed through the oil filter for removing impurities. From the filtering point, this clean lubricating oil is delivered to the different parts of the machine where lubrication is required. The oil cooler is provided in this system to keep the temperature of the lubricating oil as low as possible. Then the engine starting system. अब जो small diesel power stations हैं उनको तो manually हम start कर सकते हैं for their initial starting. But जो large diesel power generating stations हैं जहाँ stations हैं जो large diesel sets हैं उसमें हम starting by manual method से नहीं कर सकते. So in that case compressed air is used for starting. So for starting a diesel engine, initial rotation of the engine shaft is required until the firing start and the unit runs with its own power. For small DG sets, the initial rotation of the shaft is provided by handles or manually. But for large diesel power stations, compressed air is used for starting.